century of progress. 1943, the 100th birthday of B'nai B'rith. But there was little time for greetings amid the grim roar of battle. From B'nai B'rith's president, Henry Monsky, had come the inspiring directive which marshaled the hearts and hands of more than a quarter million members behind the national war effort. Immediately following the infamous attack on Pearl Harbor, Mr. Monsky wired the President of the United States that we stand ready for any and all sacrifices of blood, treasure, talent, and toil in defense of our country. We pledge all our resources and all our organizational facilities and machinery. This was done. Through the nearly 4 years of terrific struggle and heartbreak, members of the B'nai B'rith family served on every front in all branches of our victorious forces. Many made the supreme sacrifice. At home, a huge volunteer army, men, women, and youth troops, was responsible for the greatest and most extensive patriotic contribution ever made by B'nai B'rith in its long history. Here was fitting application for now immortal words. Never before have we been called upon for such a prodigious effort. Never before have we had so little time in which to do so much. And the war services were manifold, always without regard to race, color, or creed. Thus, into the archives of B'nai B'rith went another chapter of service in the wars of America. And with the day of final victory came official recognition from top echelons. The War Department's first citation for patriotic civilian service in World War II was awarded to B'nai B'rith. The Navy likewise chose B'nai B'rith for its initial honoring of a national civilian service organization. In these post-war years, inspired by the slogan, "They need us even more today," B'nai B'rith is giving impetus to a threefold program for the disabled in veterans' hospitals, for the troops still in service, and for the veteran returned to civilian life. Lodges and chapters across the nation are eagerly translating plans into action with server hospital campaigns and other vital aids in the reconditioning of the veteran. There is crying need, too, for post-war service on behalf of the oppressed peoples of foreign countries. In a broad, far-reaching scheme, constructive action has been taken with the initiation of the American Jewish Conference, which is dedicated to the many faces of human salvage abroad. B'nai B'rith's European aid program pointed toward the rehabilitation of brethren in war-ravaged lands and the re-establishment of their lodges is receiving direct support from B'nai B'rith men, women, and young folk in every part of America. The slogan is Adopt a Family, and the work is going forth with the same zeal that has typified all humane endeavors on behalf of overseas populations dating back to the pogroms in Russia under the Tsars. Volunteers salvage clothing and gather food packages for rush shipment to the stricken, wherever they have been located in devastated Europe and even distant Shanghai, China. Thousands of items move through this funnel, all bearing the name and heart of B'nai B'rith. The Netherlands government, through its offices in the United States, officially recognizes B'nai B'rith's European Relief Program. Supreme Lodge Secretary Maurice Biscayer accepts the citation, which reads, "For the innumerable tangible evidences of brotherly love by which the people of the Netherlands, encouraged and strengthened during the time of their greatest need arising from the devastation of war, were enabled to begin life anew." A memento from Maastricht, Holland completes the award.